Happy Sabbath, everyone. Welcome to Parkside Kids. In our Sabbath school lesson today, we're going to learn about the Last Supper. Our memory verse today is taken from Luke 22, verse 19. It says, "And he took bread, gave thanks and broke it, and said, 'This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me.'" Let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you so much for looking after us and keeping us safe this week. As we learn more about you, please help us to remember to share what we learn with others. In your name, amen. It's story time. Let's begin. On the first day of the Feast of Unleavened Bread, the disciples asked Jesus, "Where would you like us to plan for you to eat the Passover feast?" Jesus replied to them, "Go into the city and you will find a man. Tell him that we would like to come to his house for Passover." Firstly, what is a Feast of Unleavened Bread? And what is the Passover? These are actually the same things. The Jews celebrated the Passover ever since the time of Moses, when the Lord saved all the Israelites' firstborn babies. This was when the Lord passed over their houses and they were kept safe. During the time of the Passover celebrations, the people didn't eat or have any bread in their homes with yeast in it. Yeast is what makes the bread all big and puffy. Without yeast, the bread is flat, and that is called unleavened bread. The disciples did just as Jesus asked, and they found a place and got ready for the Passover. The evening came, and Jesus and 12 disciples sat down to eat the meal. The disciples were eating quietly because they had a lot on their minds. They were worried some people would want to kill Jesus because he was getting so popular. Jesus could see the disciples were worried. He said to them quietly, "I tell you the truth, one of you here will betray me." The disciples looked at each other in shock. Some of them asked Jesus, "It isn't me, is it, Lord?" Jesus replied, "The one who dips his bread into the bowl with me will betray me. I will die just as it is written, but the man who betrays me will feel sorry forever." Then Judas, with his head down, spoke quietly to Jesus, "It isn't me, is it?" Jesus answered, "Yes, you are the one." Judas's head went down even lower. He had hoped that the other disciples had not heard what Jesus said. Luckily, they were paying more attention to Jesus breaking apart some bread. Jesus thanked God for the bread and shared it with the disciples and said, "Take this and eat it. This is my body, which is given for you." Then he took a full cup, thanked God for it, and said, "This is my blood, which will be poured out for many people, so their sins may be forgiven." They all took a sip from the cup. The meal continued after this. It was a long celebration. The disciples took their time because they enjoyed talking with Jesus and asking him questions. After some time, Jesus got up from the table and went to a different part of the room. He covered his everyday clothes by putting a large towel around himself to look like a servant. After that, he poured water into a large bowl and began to wash the disciples' feet. Then he dried them with the towel that was wrapped around him. First of all, Jesus is like a king, but even greater than a king. He is a king of kings. By washing the disciples' feet, he was doing something that only a servant would do. When it was Peter's turn to get his feet washed, he said to Jesus, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus replied, "You don't understand what I'm doing, but you will later." "No," said Peter, "you will never wash my feet." He said this because he didn't feel right for having Jesus wash his feet. He knew Jesus was very special. Jesus replied to him, "If I don't wash your feet, you cannot be with me." "Then, Lord," Peter replied, "don't wash just my feet, but my hands and my head too." Jesus then explained that he only needed to wash his feet, and this would make his whole body clean. When Jesus had finished washing all the disciples' feet, he removed a towel from around him and returned to the table. "Do you understand what I have done for you?" Jesus asked them. "You call me teacher and Lord, and that is who I am. And now that I have washed your feet, you can also wash one another's feet." This is an example of how we should treat others. You don't have to actually wash other people's feet every day, but by doing nice things for others and acting like a servant for Jesus, that is what Jesus wants us to do. If you do these things, Jesus will bless you. Let's pray. Dear Father in heaven, thank you for loving us so much that you sent your son Jesus to be an example of how to be a servant, even though he is a king. Please help us to be humble and kind when we serve others. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hello, children.
Hello, children.
So today I'm here with my dear friend Alan.
Yeah.
And we're going to sing a song for you and hopefully with you that's called God's Love is So Wonderful. Now, you may know the song, and if you do, sing right along. If you don't, I'm pretty sure you're going to learn it very quickly, as we're going to sing it a couple times through. So join in whenever you can and sing for the Lord.
God's love is so wonderful, God's love is so wonderful, God's love is so wonderful, oh wonderful love, so high can get over it, so low can get under it. So high, can get over it, so low.
Hello again, everyone. Our story today was about the Last Supper. That's the last meal Jesus ate with his disciples. For our activity, we're going to make some unleavened bread. You'll need a baking tray lined with greaseproof paper, a mixing bowl, a mixing spoon, some spoon measurers, a knife, some measuring cups, and a rolling pin. And for the ingredients, you'll need 1 cup of wholemeal plain flour, 1/3 cup of olive oil, 1/3 cup of water, and 1/4 teaspoon of salt. So place all the ingredients into the mixing bowl. Combine to form a dough, and if the dough is too wet, just add a little more flour. When it's in a dough, then put it in the fridge to rest for about 10 minutes. Then you turn the dough out onto your floured greaseproof paper. You can roll the dough out in the baking tray or take it out on the greaseproof paper and roll the dough out on a flat surface. In the baking tray, use a knife and score the dough into squares. Bake in the oven at about 400 degrees for 15 minutes or until the bread starts to go brown at the edges. Place on a plate and with the knife, cut deeper into the squares. Separate the squares and serve. I hope you enjoy making this unleavened bread. I'd love to see how you get on. So take care. God bless. Happy Sabbath. Bye.